And good morning. Happy Monday. How is everyone today? Been a while. Probably a week. Goodness. Hey, Raimu. How have you been? How have you been? Oh, you've been trapped in the World of Warcraft. Oh dear. Wow. That's a habit I kicked a long time ago. I remember day one. Long lines to get in the door. It's a lot of fun back then. I do miss it sometimes. I don't remember seeing small attributes here. I wonder what they changed 2 days ago. Gotta retrain myself. Releases, where are you? Right here on the right. No change logs there, which I do miss. Look at this file here. Updated dependencies. Dependencies, 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 dependencies. Ooh, temporarily downgrade async executor. Fancy. I gotta figure out what to do today. I was thinking that I did want to get back into the AWS stuff. But that'd be fun to jump in with something else, just to play around a little bit. It's a bevy one with one V, apparently. Might be fun to try this out. Very early stages of development. What is our roadmap? Let's take a quick peek at that. Oh, I've never used the GitHub little roadmap bits. That's interesting. The project cards, whatever this is called. Project planning screen. First, I do not like that I can't scroll the whole screen. I have to scroll each, what do we call these? Swim lanes or something? iOS support. Ooh, nice. Should be possible to run Bevy apps on iOS. Where does this take us? Oh, it's an issue. Oh, interesting. So there are in progress issues. That could be fun. Let's see, where is my terminal? Well, that and I've got some gloves on today. Very thin gloves, but they are just enough to hit some neighboring keys. Yeah, look at that. I train myself again. And where did battle end up? Let's take a look at battle. Check on Frank for a moment. I know I also have battle on Frank. Where's Frank? Is it Bob? Oh, there it is. It's Bob. Ah, the gloves failed. There we go. Gonna be a lot of that today. Do I happen to know why async functions cannot be used for tests? You can use async functions in tests. You just have to have the right wrapper around them. So, if you're using Tokyo, I but small has something similar. I know I've used small inside of tests. And Tokyo has utils, which provides, I think, a macro or something that allows you to use a Tokyo test. Where is that? Oh, is it not there? Tokyo test? Got all sorts of stuff in here for this. If I remember correctly, they also, maybe it's not in here, maybe it's in the main Tokyo repo. But there is a way to set it up. Oh yeah, I mean, wrapping it with just block on would work fine. Here. But Tokyo has a test macro, which lets you just have an async function. Well, if you're allergic to Tokyo, you don't get the goodness here. Also, 0.3, I think, had some decent improvements. Feels like we're missing something. Shoot, you know what? I think I pulled the wrong project. What's in here? Yeah, that looks a little bit more like what I was expecting. All right, no Genesis over there, that's fine. Let's go into server. In web. Just to read me. Battle test, got FE test. What were we doing here? Let's see, we've got cargo, we've got battle test, FE test, and target. What were we pulling in here? Warp, Tokyo, Yart. OpenID Connect. Oh, that's right. We were trying to log in with Twitch. Getting a little web page thing set up. That's right. Gumdrop. Oh, that's for argument parsing. Sorte, rand, log. Auto logger, parking lot. Okay. So what were we doing? We were testing to see how long it would take to run a battle. And I think what we had ended up doing was, let's see, we're using auto logger, that's fine. Loading the configs, running the battle. And then we have our stats thing, which we're, I guess, dumping out. It's fine. Seems fairly straightforward. I think there was something that I remember recently. I think we can improve the speed on this. So we're going to first. Yeah. Think we can use like FastRand instead. As long as we can. Oh, that's right. We had a whole bunch of stuff. Oh, remember when we did the SIMD stuff with this? That was a lot of fun. Remember that. Look at that. Prefetch. She just yanked that out. All right. Looks like it's complaining about the line 252, 252. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and comment this whole section there out. And where's COC? Oh, cargo X task install. There we go. Get that built up. It's going a lot faster than I thought it would. Or is it building the builder? I don't remember. Yes, it's compiling X task. It'll go through and do the next part. Looks like it was working on it. There we go. Don't really care that much. Oh man. I'm going to go through and look at this. What this was a full kind of battle simulation with some rules. Now, if I remember correctly, there were a couple of issues with this. One of them was how much memory it ended up using. It would use a lot of memory at once. The other one was that it took a long time to generate randomness. I think part of that is going to be this small RNG. Oops, what's that doing? Okay, it's still going. Want to try running this. Cargo. Brr. Let's see if we can get the help. Rust analyzer is taking a while to get going. How's the volume today? Is the music louder than me? I can't tell. Actually, I could go and test that out. I'll load this up in a different browser. Music's barely audible. Okay. I'm going to try to increase that a touch. All right. Well, hopefully it doesn't drown out the vocals. I was gonna say voice. This feels like such a weird word for that. All right. Where does it? Where did it go? Oh, it's still sitting there. Why is it not going? What a fun little song. Is this taking forever? Come on, okay, I get that the CPU is probably bottlenecked because of this build. However, this here. Got a lot of tracing that's going on, just fine. All right. We spawn some ships. This is going to be a bit of... Let's take a peek. What is that doing? Spawn ships. We create an armada. Then for everything inside of there... What is this? The different aspects of the ships are stored in different factories so that we can use multi-core systems more efficiently. Oh, I remember. That's right. That's right. So these are all indexed by, I think it was by ship, right? So we have a vector for each one of these different properties, and then each one of the properties is indexed by ship index. So depending on the kind of the ship, we specify the different resource. Got it. And that didn't actually take that long. This was more just a ton of initialization. And because there aren't that many ships in the armada, etc., it doesn't take that long to iterate through and build them. Should probably be debug a cert. All right. Oh, I see. That was in the tests. Run battle. There we go. Then we have the entropy. So depending on the number of rounds, we iterate over this over and over and over again. We build the attack. What does FastRand have for that sort of API? Let's take a peek at the docs. Not cryptographically secure. That's fine. Shuffle an array. So I imagine getting something that's within a range. Say you just wanted a random number between like 0 and 100. How would you do that? You would probably take the F32, multiply that out. Is there a different way? Oh, you can give it range bounds. Oh, nice. Okay. Well, that's handy. I wonder how they do that. So what is this I-32 doing? Is it... What's it do with range? So they get the low and the high. Self.gen as T. What is this? What is gen? And why does it have a dollar sign? Oh. Oh, I see. Because it's basically the same thing for all of the different types, isn't it? Ah, got it. So Jen is there. I see. So we should look at, let's say, Jen U32. Where is that defined? That pulled in. Oh, there it is. So that just returns a U32. I lost it. Oh, I see. This is if it's minimum and max are the range of that type, and they just generate it and return it. Otherwise, what are they doing here? The length. So the high value. Wrapping sub low. Wrapping add one. Okay. Oh, interesting. And where is mod? Mod. So we end up using the gen mod U32. FN gen mod U32. So the total there. Got it. Okay. Go back. Alright. This is taking much too long. Let's see, we've got 6 more crates to build there. Not too bad. 5. That's going fairly good. And this, can we just do a cargo run? No. How about we do .slash target debug. Yeah. to go. Do we not have battle test in there? There's a lot of other stuff. I don't see a battle test. Stepped in. Ooh, down to two or three, depending on how you count it. Hey, cat peasant! Yes, long time no see here, or something, yeah. Yeah, I've got my fantastic ugly Christmas sweater on. It is a goat sweater. It's got a goat on it wearing a... never mind. It's just a fantastic ugly sweater. This is the season. Alright. So hopefully this finishes out real quick. Or quick enough. I'm gonna pour some more water. And my machine is just dragging today. How have you been, cat peasant? Oh, look, it finished. Yay. All right. We are working on an old project. I call it Battle. Or Genesis. I think I call it Genesis. It's named after a satellite. Alright. Cargo run, dash dash, help. Interesting. I thought this already compiled. We did a check. We didn't... There we go. Unrecognized option, help. Oh, really? If I run it on its own, it's missing config. Okay. All right, what are my options? Load config. Args. Oh, okay. To a config file. Battle one, sure. Maybe we should have looked at what battle one was. We have these different ships, transports, cruisers, etc. So it's basically this person's armada. Those are the kinds of ships. Down here we have the offense. And then the defense. Let's enable some logging. There we go. So spawning didn't take long at all. But here they have, what, a million? A million units here. So we're simulating some giant space battle. But the space battle is kind of done, I guess, similar to how like how old armies with muskets would fight. They would all line up and then start shooting. So let's look at the stats here. So the offense for ship kind one. Used a lot of shields. I don't remember how many of these kinds we had. But a lot of its shields got used. A lot of these were destroyed. You can see how much energy was wasted, okay. Alright, so it's saying that that took 31 seconds. I'm gonna run it again, just for fun this time. Then I want to swap out the fast rand for that other rand. So I suspect that that's taking a long time. You can tell that the first battle takes the longest. See, how far can we go back? Your attack duration is 9 seconds. Is that the first one? Yeah, 9 seconds. Almost 10. Alright. Cargo to Tommel. Ah, wrong one. We're going to get this one out. Cargo add fast rand. Ah. Okay, so that should have broken a number of things. Hey, morning, Museum. How are ya? So, random is another one? Is there a preference for one versus the other? Oh, it doesn't offer a global. Here's a little comparison, okay. Now, does it also offer, let's look at the docs. Use the same algo. From state, rand. All right, so we can say rand range, which is, I think, what we need. Requires that range.end is less than or equal to range.start. I think this is going to give us everything that we need. Let's try that. Yeah, there we go. I'm typing with gloves on today. It's cold out here. I got used to the warmth. All right, so if we wanted one of these, we could provide a seed or not. From state, interesting. Let's just give it a seed. Some number. Oh, what is this? Look at this. That's cute. You know, I didn't do a COC restart after we updated. Well, that's different. Oh, that's neat. It implements a 32-bit version of PCG. Let's get rid of that. We'll go into build attack. What is this taking? R. Oh, where R is an iterator. We're just gonna pass the RNG in. Does this have right? No. Was it Ren 32? Restart that. It's nice having the little percent down there. We're just calling it RNG. Oh, that's interesting. That's a neat idea. To wrap that in an iterator of random numbers. Well, that's pretty neat. Choose multiple fill. Oh, I see. Hey, Sure Shack. Long time. It's been like a week. Back a little bit. I wonder. It's interesting. Okay, where were we? I wish I hadn't deleted all that code now. You like how Fastran does it? You know what? I'm just going to go back over here. Save. Gdiff split. I want to keep the distribution bit here. What was I using here? And here. Yeah, they are always under that. Here it is. I had forgotten what I was using as the bound here. Zeesh died. That was a pretty quick stop there. Releases. All right, let's get the latest. Copy link location. I wonder where I have that. Ah, there. This is really high tech here. We've got so much bandwidth. All right. Take two. Where were we? We were here, creating this. Ren range. And this is going to be, oh, that's right, standard hitter. What was it? Pump function, that's what it is. There we go. Oh, and it returns an option. Oh, of course, so it knows when to stop. Something like that with... There we go. I guess that's inclusive, isn't it? Well, what was this doing before? This defense length here, uniform new, is this inclusive? Oh, it's not inclusive. All right, so we'll keep it the same then. Oh, U32. Almost. What was it before? Oh, U size here. Same thing here. Offense length. That means we'll have the same issue here. Hmm. And those are all in the front end test. Okay. Let's get it built first. Oh, it's running. I'm going to stop it first. It didn't seem like it was all that much faster. I'd always thought that the random generation was going to be the slow part there. We come up to the top. Where is it? There it is. Oh, in debug mode. Yes. Thank you for that. Which also means that the previous test was incorrect. Oops. There I go, holding the key down. All right. Right, after it starts, I'll run it again. We're doing really, really rough timings here, but not that bad. All right. Oh, you've got to be kidding. That took no time at all. Let's check this one out and run it again. First, where was time? Oh, there it is. That doesn't look like what I'm looking for. L dash V. I don't think I have V on this system. Just L and P. What's hyperfine? What is hyperfine? All right, we'll give this an install. Sorry, I have a little visitor. All right. Oh, by the Bat SD guy. Oh, neat. All right. That's actually almost done. That looks pretty cool, though. Give it a warm up. So you can see what the difference is there. Nice. Huh. Very cool. All right, let's give this a try. Let's see what it does with just the default args. Ah, we need this. Oh, look at that. That little ASCII art. Fancy. Oh, we just call it binary? Probably. Then I'd have to find the binary. Target release. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Okay. Oh, that's cool. You can have him compare the two. All right, copy, dot, dot. Target release, battle test to battle. All right, now let's get log. I think we want this one. Cargo build release. Ah, that's right. Get rid of this. Alright, so let's give that a copy. Copy to target. Oh, I see. Was it config? Yeah, dash dash config. Okay. I forgot what it was. No. Config. BATTLE. 0001.toml. That's taking way too long. I shouldn't do that. We compiled this and released, didn't we? That just took forever. Alright. Oh, I see. If you print to standard error, it fails. Okay. Yep, 1584, both of them. Oh, random. Dash dash config dot slash battle 0001.toml. All right, well, it looks like that one test takes 30 seconds. So, I mean, this is pretty substantial performance improvement. I'm really surprised about that. Like, it's, you know, cryptographically secure randomness takes time. Mm-hmm. It's taking its sweet time. Guess we'll get some good measurements though. Minutes. Oh, because I thought it was just going to take. Oh, current estimate. That's. Well, when it's done, we'll have. It'll be done, right? ETA. Well, it says it's going to take 1:50 on the right there. Hopefully it drops down when it gets into like, oh, 2.5 minutes of, well, it'd be a shame to waste it at this point, wouldn't it? We'll just let it run. We're going to use the machine doing other stuff at the same time, which I'm sure is absolutely fair. We just won't save. All right, well, here it's got 1 minute left. And hopefully, yeah, this is a really cool tool. Hopefully, it'll show us that OORandom is just insanely faster than RAND. But of course, it's not cryptographically secure, which is fine because we're not using it for anything that's security-based. Alright, because 28 seconds plus the other run. I'm looking forward to this. Man, I have missed streaming. I woke up today because I was telling myself I was going to do some streaming. Then I get out here and everything is like. I had to update, let's see, Pretzel. I had to update OBS. I even had to wait for my computer to charge a little bit. Let's see. Yeah, the first one is rather consistent. Why does it think it's going to take 3 minutes? It was going so much faster before. This doesn't seem right. Wasn't it? It was like 10 seconds. This doesn't seem right to me. Does this seem right to you guys? planned this before. It was going so much faster. I thought previously when we benchmarked this, it was 10 seconds or just a couple seconds. Well, that's too bad. Did I somehow override it? Now, when we ran this before, or was it? Here. This is a lot faster. How many of these battle 001s do we have? Look at the target thing. Oh, did I copy the wrong one? Oh, I see. So they're. Hold on. Yeah, I don't even have a target in there. Yeah. Yeah, that's taking a long time. I only have one config for Battle 001. Cargo run. Oh, that's the old one. FD-E Tommel. Oh yeah. See, I'm not good with FD yet. CD. I see. So they are different sizes. Maybe it was crashing before? No, but Hyperfine would have alerted us. That is so strange. That's it. It's fast now. Okay. What is it? It's dot dot slash. Target, release, battle test. Okay, I don't know what happened. Maybe I copied the same thing over. But it looks much, much faster. So if we look at the stats here, some of the tracing with OO random, the attack duration is half a second, where it was over 9 seconds for Rand. That's a big chunk. Okay, that was fun getting back into that. Think we're gonna keep the O random. I wanna see. Wait, didn't we have? Oh, we already have O2. Those are also fairly big. What about three? Count. Yeah, that one's a little larger. It has 10 million of that ship. How many here? 10? Okay. So if I run this with three. Ah, I think the config file format changed. Yeah. Come back over here. Four. We're just gonna bump up the size here. We have a million. So let's toss. That should take a wee bit longer. Oops. We're going to do this with Ash. Oh, to compare the three. Oh, that's cool. So you can have parameters, parameter N. Gotcha. Well, this one's probably going to take a lot longer, actually. I'm going to run this without Hyperfine, just to see. This for 100 million? And there is an L flag for parameterizing the command. Oh, I see. Oh, that's cool. That's really cool. Okay, so that thing is using 3 gigs of RAM currently. And only one core. That's right, we're going to split that up amongst cores. Let's do that. What do I think about the Rust programming language? I quite like it. I quite like it. I've done Java, C, C++, Erlang, Elixir. And I think it solves a common set of problems. You end up paying for those costs up front, which is really nice. And quite frankly, it makes you think about these issues a little bit earlier when you go back to those other languages. Let's see. So let's say we did want to run this battle, but we wanted to parameterize and generate reports with it is nice. Hyperfine is pretty cool. It's so easy to use so far. It's just run it. Oh, for regression tracking and stuff. Oh, nice. So spawning the ships doesn't seem to take all that long. But this here, where we want to be able to share this memory across CPUs. It's really in the building of the attack. So how do we split this across CPUs? What is this doing? This does two things. So, for every ship that's attacking, there's a target. And we need to modify the ship that's attacking. It loses energy. Then we need to apply that attack. So we could either split it up into pipelines, right? Different CPUs do like the first, the second, the third piece, or we split the workload up across CPUs. Problem is going to be how much we can parallelize this. We either need to have very small locks or rearrange how this is set up. We cannot guarantee that two ships aren't attacking the same thing at the same time, but we can guarantee that the same ship isn't attacking two things at once. I think this is going to be the exercise for tomorrow. But jump into that again. So I've got a ton of email to catch up on. Now it's been a while. We are going to raid Rimo today. So, if you want to catch me offline, you can always pop into the Discord. Where is it? Is the bot in there? The bot is there. And we have archives over there. So, until next time, y'all. Bye-bye.